Step 3. Creating exterior walls. In this step, we'll add exterior walls to the project. We'll also discuss some of the smart and intuitive feature sets of ArchiCAD. These can be efficiently used throughout all phases of the architectural design development process. Switch back to the view map of the navigator. Activate the first preset view located in the 2.3 Creating Exterior Walls folder of the navigator's view map. Activate the wall tool in the toolbox. Make sure that the straight wall geometry method is selected in the info box. In the favorites palette, activate the wall 1 favorite by double-clicking its name in the list. Notice the location of label 1 on the floor plan. Hold down the space key and notice that the shape of the cursor has changed to a so-called magic wand. Move the cursor towards the edge of the mass polygon and notice that the shape of the cursor changes again when it's moved above the edge. Now, click the edge of the mass polygon with the magic wand-shaped cursor to create the wall along the perimeter of the mass polygon. Please remember, when you keep the spacebar pressed while clicking an element edge, ArchiCAD will take any consecutive path of edges the clicked edge is part of and will use that polyline for the geometry of the newly created element. In this case, we have the wall tool active, so it will create walls. The consecutive reference lines of those walls will now lie along the contour of the mass polygon. Activate the next preset view in the navigator view map to display the 3D window. You can see all the exterior walls that were created in this step. These are multi-story walls extending from the ground floor up to the top of the second floor. Activate the next preset view in the view map. Notice the location of label 1 on the floor plan. Now, space-click anywhere on the edge of the mass polygon. This will create the other sequence of exterior walls. Activate the next preset view located in the view map. This will display all the walls created so far in 3D. Activate the 2.3.5 preset view in the view map. Activate the marquee tool in the toolbox. Select the All Stories, that is the thick marquee icon, selection method in the info box. Draw a selection rectangle by clicking close to label 1.1 and label 1.2 to define the diagonal of the selection rectangle. Activate the next preset view located in the view map. In the front area of the 3D view, you can see the selection profile of the exterior wall we just created. Notice that this is a wall with a complex profile with some zinc covering at the top. This shows one of ArchiCAD's great features, which is the possibility to create such section profiles and apply them to walls, columns, and beams to create the exact geometry we need. Select the Design, Complex Profiles, Profile Manager menu item to go to the Profile Manager dialog. From the Choose Profile drop-down list, select the External Concrete plus Brick Veneer profile. Click the Edit Chosen Profile button. Use the mouse to zoom to the top of the profile. This graphic editing viewpoint is similar to the floor plan. Here you can create the exact section profile of the structure you wish to create using fills and lines. Close the Profile Manager without saving any changes. Activate the next preset view and return to the floor plan. Right-click on an empty area and select the Remove Marquee menu item from the context menu to remove the marquee from the floor plan. You can also press the Escape key once for the same result. Make sure that the Suspend Groups toggle in the standard toolbar is switched on. Switch it on if it's off. Activate the arrow tool from the toolbox, and make sure that the quick selection method is switched on in the info box. Hover your cursor over the lower horizontal side of the wall indicated by label 1 and keep your cursor over it. A thick blue pre-selection outline appears around the wall. The shape of the cursor changes to a Mercedes cursor, meaning that you found a line or an edge of an element. When the Mercedes cursor is thick, it means that it has found the reference line of a wall or a beam. A small info tag also appears and lists some of the most important data about the element. This becomes very handy when you have several elements on top of each other. Select the View, On-Screen View Options, Walls and Beams Reference Lines menu item to show the reference line of walls. The reference line of a wall is a thick line with a direction. This is important because walls are created based on their reference lines. Further, for walls to be intersected and joined properly, they must have their reference lines accurately intersected and joined. As you can see, currently the reference lines of these walls are on the outside edges of the exterior walls. This will be important in later steps. Select the View, On-Screen View Options, Walls and Beams Reference Lines menu item again to hide wall reference lines. Select the horizontal wall indicated by label 1 by clicking on it. When a wall is selected, the two endpoints of its reference line are marked with hotspots. You can drag these hotspots to other positions in order to stretch the wall. Select the Edit, Reshape, Stretch menu item to stretch the selected wall. Hover your cursor over the right endpoint of the wall's reference line. The shape of the cursor changes from arrow to arrow with a thick check mark. The arrow with the check mark cursor means that ArchiCAD has found a point or hotspot belonging to an element. The arrow with the thick check mark means that this point is on the reference line of a wall or beam. Since we want to stretch the wall, we need to find either end of its reference line. We know from the shape of the cursor whether we have found the correct point. Click the right end point of the wall's reference line. This will start the stretch operation. When stretching, you need to define with two clicks which endpoint or node of an element you want to move to which other position. Start moving your cursor horizontally to the right at close to a 0-degree angle to your first clicked point. As you can see, a dashed line appears to help you in your graphic input. This is called a guideline. The cursor gravitates along guidelines, meaning it will move along them to help your work. Type 12,770 on your keyboard. When you start entering a numerical value in your keyboard, the tracker immediately interprets it as an input into whichever field name is displayed in bold. The default field is the distance field, so the value 12,770 is entered into this field. In the case of stretching a wall, this means that this is going to be the new length of the wall measured from its opposite endpoint. Press the Enter key to accept this drag vector distance. The vector's angle will be 0.00 degrees since you have your cursor on the guideline. The length of the wall changes to the specified length. With the wall still selected, switch to the Wall tool in the toolbox. Hover your cursor over the left edge of the wall, joining the middle of the wall you've just stretched. You should have the thick Mercedes cursor appear, signaling that you've found the reference line of the wall. Press and hold down the Control key on Windows, or the Command key on Macintosh. With the key pressed, click the reference line of the joining wall. The selected horizontal wall will be split in two at the intersection of the reference lines of the two walls, with the shorter new wall segment remaining selected. With the wall still selected, apply the Wall 2 favorite by double-clicking the favorite's name in the favorites palette. We applied a wall favorite to change certain settings of the selected wall segment. Select the Move, drag a copy menu item from the context menu. Click anywhere on the lower horizontal edge of the selected wall to specify the first point of the drag vector. Start moving your cursor downward and type 7740 on your keyboard and then press the Enter key. A copy of the wall will be created at the specified distance, and this copy will remain selected after the operation. With the copied wall segment still selected, apply the Wall 3 favorite by double-clicking its name in the Favorites palette. Activate the 2.3.8 preset view from the view map. This will display the opposite side of the other wing of the building. Here, we've already done the same wall modification steps to save time.